one night I had a dream about this one giant fat lionfish coming up out of the Gulf of Mexico, scraping one side on Louisiana, the other on the Yucatan, and just coming up onto the land. That was just one giant nightmare. We knew they were coming. When you looked at their placement on a map, they were on either side of us. We were caught in a pincer movement. It was inevitable that they were coming to Texas.
We're very concerned as a scientific community about the lionfish because there's a lot at stake. Recreational fishing, commercial fishing is huge in the state of Texas in our offshore waters.
In their native Indo-Pacific, they have natural predators. Here, the predators really haven't learned how to deal with these animals yet.
The ecosystem is in a very delicate balance. So when you throw in a species like lionfish, we really don't know what will happen, but we're pretty sure it's not going to be good. So Texas Parks and Wildlife organized this symposium to bring together experts and really just see what we know and how could we come together collectively to figure out how to solve this problem.
We had seven different areas, such as outreach, funding, legislation, control, all these different areas. And now we're going through the process of figuring out a hierarchy, good ideas, bad ideas. And then we're going to do which ones are practical, how much do they cost? And that's what the second Lionfish Symposium is going to be about.
We had several community events, for example, down at the aquarium. And there were panel discussions and presentations to make the general public aware of the problem and what they faced.
At the Texas State Aquarium, we have the opportunity to educate others. We have a lionfish exhibit that puts that particular invasive species in people's face. They're able to become aware, and it gives us an opportunity to educate them.
We should realize that the introduction of a predator species into a huge ecosystem, it touches a lot of different things, and a lot more than people might expect.
It's not going to find Nemo or find Dory. In fact, the lionfish is probably going to eat Nemo and Dory, and that'll be the end of that story.
Some of the guys that I work with, they said it's pretty tasty, and they want more.
Having Texas Parks and Wildlife step up, organize this symposium so that we can be ready shows great leadership, and I'm very pleased to see that.
Until the future looks a little bit brighter in terms of dealing with the lionfish along the Texas coast because of the symposium, and then because of the efforts of the group, all the collaborative group working together.
I'm really proud of Texas Parks and Wildlife. The team we assembled is great, and all it took was asking. Everybody who was already too busy made time for this because we all recognized how important it was. I don't know where their time came from, but I know that there was a lot of heavy lifting, and you can't ask for a better bunch of people.